Okay. So hey, I wanted to cast right there. That is a nice one.
Hello everyone, the Holy Moly Fisherman here with a video about the creation of the new Holy Moly fishing cart. My current fishing cart, as you can see here, is one of those collapsible portable shopping carts. These things work great under the right circumstances, but as you can see from my next picture, I have kind of outgrown it. This is just some of the gear I take out if I'm just fishing by myself and doesn't include any of the fishing gear that I need to take when my family goes out fishing. The majority of my fishing is from the bank, and sometimes I have to walk a long way to get to my fishing spot. So a fishing cart to get my gear to my fishing spot is a must for me. Another downside of my current fishing cart, besides the capacity, are the narrow hard wheels. If the ground is soft, or if it's sand, these wheels have a tendency to dig into the ground, making the cart a little harder to pull. So when making my new fishing cart, I came to the decision that I definitely needed to use pneumatic wheels on it. My son and I started researching out homemade fishing carts online, and we came across a bunch of different and awesome designs that other people had created for themselves that met their fishing needs. So after seeing this, we decided to create something that would satisfy our basic requirements. 1. Pneumatic wheels. The fishing cart needs to be able to travel across multiple types of surfaces smoothly. 2. The capacity. The fishing cart needs to be able to handle fishing gear for multiple people. 3. Breaks down into pieces. The fishing cart needs to break down into multiple pieces for easy transportation. 4. Rod holders. I wanted to integrate rod holders into the fishing cart so I have an easier way to take multiple fishing rods with me. And last but not least, 5. Looks cool. The fishing cart has to look cool, right? After my son and I sketched out a bunch of different designs, I went online and purchased a bunch of 1-inch PVC fittings from an online supplier, since they were cheaper to buy online than at my local home improvement store. I got multiple tees, 4-way crosses, 45-degree elbows, 90-degree elbows, and other miscellaneous fittings that I thought we needed to build the cart. I got some 13-inch pneumatic wheels from our local Harbor Freight, along with a 5/8 threaded rod, lock nuts, and washers to use for the axles on the fishing cart. I'll have to apologize in advance, but I do not have any of the PVC pipe measurements that we cut because we just started cutting and fitting together pieces as we needed them to start creating the basic overall design of the fishing cart. This was a lot of trial and error designing, so I would suggest definitely drawing out plans in advance. But since this was a father and son project, I wanted him to experience all aspects from the designing to the actual building of the fishing cart and to learn from it what is needed to be done next time to make it go more smoothly. Now to move on to the building of the fishing cart and what we came up with. First, the rear wheel and axle assembly. Here I started with making the supports for the right and left sides of the rear wheel assembly. I used a section of PVC pipe to house the threaded axle. I drilled slightly oversized holes into 1-inch PVC plugs that were cemented into both sides of the PVC cross fitting to support the threaded rod. And then to attach the wheels, I used 5/8 lock nuts and washers. Now time to build the front wheel assembly. Once again, I made the right and left support brackets to support the front wheel. I drilled oversized holes into the 1-inch PVC plugs to support the axle. I then used 5/8 threaded rod for the axle and secured the wheel to it with washers and lock nuts. Next, assembling the fishing cart base. Now, creating the base of the fishing cart was probably the most challenging part of the entire project. Once we knew how our wheel assemblies were going to work, we then had to get them attached to the base of the fishing cart. We also had to make sure that the base had enough support so it would be able to support the weight of the fishing gear, along with having connecting points for both sides and the fishing cart handle. You can see that I was having a difficult time remembering how the pieces to the fishing cart base went together. I eventually got it figured out. Now to show you how both wheel assemblies attach to the base of the fishing cart. It's really quite simple. The sports just slipped into the 1-inch PVC tees. We didn't cement these nor secure them with pins because I was confident that the weight of the fishing gear would keep the wheel assemblies in place. Now to make the fishing cart sides. Using 1-inch PVC elbows, tees, and some sections of pipe, we made the sides as you can see here. At this point, I also used 2 1-inch PVC tees that would be used to attach the rod holders to. Now to make the fishing cart handle and rod holders. We used 1-inch PVC 90-degree elbows and some pieces of PVC pipe to make a basic handle for the fishing cart, nothing fancy. For the rod holders, we also used some 90-degree PVC elbows along with some 1-inch to 1/2-inch PVC couplers. This would allow me to easily attach my bite alarms and rod butt holders to them if I needed to use the fishing cart as a secondary rod pod. I decided to use a piece of corrugated plastic cardboard, the same stuff that the yard signs are made of, to put over the fishing cart base. I cut the corners out so it would fit around the open ends of the PVC fittings that the sides attach to. I used these self-tapping screws to secure the corrugated plastic cardboard to the fishing cart base. I put screws around all 4 corners and then halfway in between the sides to hold the corrugated plastic cardboard in place. Using the self-tapping screws along with a cordless drill made this job a breeze. Now that all the pieces are made, it's time to put the fishing cart together and see how it looks. I can't wait. I started with the fishing cart base first and turned it over. I then attached the rear wheel and front wheel assemblies to the base before flipping it back over. I then attached both sides to the base of the fishing cart, followed by the fishing cart handle and a piece of PVC pipe I cut for the front to hold the sides together. Now to attach the rod holders to each one of the fishing cart's 4 corners. Having the fishing cart basically assembled, I noticed that I could use the fishing cart handle to support a removable table that can be used for tying rigs, cutting up bait, and so on. I got a piece of high density plastic similar to what is used for cutting boards. I epoxied some pieces of 1-inch PVC pipe near the corners to hold it in place. Now it can be used by the handle area or be placed across the tops of the fishing cart sides. And here we have it, the Holy Moly fishing cart fully assembled and just in need of some paint. But before it was painted, I noticed that we overlooked something. The piece of PVC pipe that connects the signs together at the front could possibly separate as a fishing cart is being used. So, to reinforce this piece, I purchased some 1/4-inch hitch pins and drilled oversized holes through the three-way PVC fitting and the connecting PVC pipe and pinned them together so they wouldn't come apart. Now it's time for paint. We decided to use the color olive green. Now it is important to use some light grit sandpaper or one of those green Scotch-Brite pads to dull the surface of the PVC pipe and fittings. By dulling the surface, it will give the paint something to stick to so it doesn't wear off. I started off by spray painting the sides and top until my first spray paint can ran out, and I had to grab my second can to finish off hitting the areas that I had originally missed and to paint what I could on the bottom of the cart. I then turned it over and painted the bottom of it. Here's what the fishing cart looks like with two coats of paint, just waiting for a matte clear coat finish. So here it is, the Holy Moly fishing cart, fully assembled with two coats of the olive green paint and three coats of matte clear coat. We are very pleased on how it turned out. Now let's load it up with some fishing gear to see how it works. And here we go. I've put on there both my fishing rods, marker float rod, tackle box, bait bucket, fishing chair, fishing net, fishing table, and my bait cooler, and there is room to spare. I really hope you enjoyed this video about the Holy Moly fishing cart, and stay tuned for our next video when we put the Holy Moly fishing cart to use to see how it performs. Don't forget to subscribe to the Holy Moly Fisherman channel on YouTube and check out our other videos. Tight lines to everybody, and thanks for watching.